following is a video presentation of an evening worship service at Orrville Baptist Church.
Well, good evening, everybody.
Good evening.
I'm glad to see all of you tonight. We could close the doors in the back, Charlie, if you don't mind. Thank you. Well, welcome to our 2019 Vacation Bible School Commencement Service. I'm very glad to see all of you here. Just as we have done every day of Vacation Bible School, we're going to begin our service tonight by saying our pledges to the flags and to the Bible. So if you would please stand as we begin our time together. We'll give our pledge first to the American flag over here to your right. Attention, salute, pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Next, we'll give our pledge to the Christian flag. Attention, salute, pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the Christian flag and to the Savior for whose kingdom it stands. One brotherhood, uniting all Christians in service and in love.
And lastly, we have our pledge to the Bible. Hold that up real high, Jason. There we go. Attention, salute, pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the Bible, God's holy word, and will make it a lamp to my feet, a light unto my path, and hide its words in my heart, that I might not sin against God.
Thank you. You may be seated. Thank you, guys. You're absolutely. Just on the front row there, Jesus. All right. So, again, I want to extend a welcome to you. This is the third year that we will have done a Vacation Bible School commencement service. And I think this has become a really good tradition for us to have to celebrate the conclusion of what has definitely been a fun and a filled week of good stuff and learning about the Bible and learning about Jesus. And we have most definitely been doing that. We will go through a little recap in just a few minutes about everything that we've gone over every day of this week, but I want to begin our time with a moment of prayer, so if you would please bow with me. One thing that our kids have been learning, and I hope that they have enjoyed as much as we've enjoyed watching them, is some music. So we're going to have our Vacation Bible School theme song at this time, so I'm asking you to do if you would stand, please, as we go through this. And kids, just as every night we've had, and you're welcome to dance and do the motions until your heart's content, all right?
Amazing encounter, believers, surprise, incredible wonders, I pray.
also been learning a weekly motto and a memory verse that our kids have gotten to know really well. I think they've probably gotten maybe a little put out with me the number of times that I've had to say it over and over again, but I think it's a good one for them to learn. So our motto has been zoom in, focus on Jesus. So I'd invite you to say this with me. Zoom in, focus on Jesus. Amen. Then the next one that we've been learning, our memory verse, is from the book of John, chapter 20, verse 31. And I'll read it one time and then we'll repeat it in just a minute. But listen to the word of God. It says, "But these are written that ye might believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that believing ye might have life through his name." Let's say that together, if you will, please. "But these are written that ye might believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that believing ye might have life through his name." The book of John, chapter 20, verse 31. What we've been learning every day throughout our 4 days of Vacation Bible School has been really the story of Jesus, how the kids have learned why he came to earth and his journey here on earth, ending up all the way through where we are today. So we started with the point that Jesus knew why he came. Jesus came to the earth for our salvation, so that all of us may be saved from our sins. He came to love, to heal, to forgive. Some great words from one of our great hymns. On the second day, we learned that Jesus is the Son of God, that he proved to us that he was. He was the Messiah, meaning the Savior of the world. He was baptized, something that John did for him to show that he was a follower. And that's something that we do as when we become Christians, is we are baptized to show that we are followers of Jesus Christ, following in his example. And then lastly, that he followed God's plan. Jesus was fully God and fully man, but he knew why he was here. He had the plan from his Father, and he knew before time that he would have to die for your sins and for mine. On the third day, we showed further that Jesus proved that he was God's Son. We learned about the miracles that he performed here on earth, how he showed, you know, the aspects of faith to his disciples, and that he truly was the Son of God. And then lastly, yesterday, we talked about Jesus' resurrection from the dead. Probably the greatest event in our history here in this world, where Jesus conquered death, he conquered sin by raising from the grave so that you and I could be saved. And we learned the value of that on just yesterday. So we've been learning a lot of stuff. We've been doing a lot of stuff. The kids have been working on some really good crafts that I think we have some examples that we'll show you. But one other thing that I have enjoyed doing for the last 3 years is putting together a brief video for you of some of the pictures and the videos that have been taken over the course of the week. So this will be something that we can sit back and just enjoy for a few minutes, and I hope you do. All of you tonight, if you're happy to be and excited to be in Vacation Bible School, I want you to give me a good.
In the wild, in the wild. makes the leopard spots, makes horses neigh and trot, gives bees their paws and bears their fuzz and ladybugs their dots. Who gives a zebra stripes, makes penguins black and white? God does. And if you want to know it more and find out what you're made for, admit to God that you're a sinner and repent. Believe that Jesus is the Son of God. See, confess your faith in Jesus Christ as Savior and Lord. That's what you're made for.
Okay, I'll walk over there. of friends.
This time I'd like to invite the pastor if he'd come up and have a few remarks.
Thankfully that was whipped cream, not shaving cream, obviously. Not getting any shaving cream on this face. But thank you all for being here tonight. And thank you to volunteers and teachers and those who helped make this week wonderful. And I want to thank all of you for attending and giving me a good week. I hope you had a fun week of VBS. You're the reason I had a good week and enjoyed this week and just being with you and going through the Bible with you. I do want to kind of remind you guys, this is my last chance for the week to remind you guys of all that we talked about this week and the big themes. You remember every time we were together, we talked about purpose. And this is a message for all of us here tonight. All that we see in creation, it all serves purpose. You guys remember us talking about bees one night? You remember that? What would happen if all the bees just suddenly vanished tomorrow? What would happen? We wouldn't have very much, would we? Our food would start going away. Our trees start going away. We need bees. And it's small things like that we overlook, but they serve a great purpose in God's creation. So there's purpose in all these things. And we talked about encounters with Jesus and how they were all purposeful. And the one I want you to remember, my favorite of all that we talked about this week, remember the Roman soldier who saw the crucified Jesus? Remember that part? We went through that.
Yes.
Yes. The best part was the confession of the Roman soldier. Remember? We see all of these purposes, and they come from sometimes even places we don't expect. And you might expect one of the disciples or Mary to say it, but remember the enemy of Jesus, the Roman soldier, the one who helped put him on the cross. At the end of seeing all that happened, he said, "Truly, this is the Son of God." And that goes along with our motto and our verse for the week. We were given the scriptures that we would know Jesus, that we would have salvation through knowledge of him. And because of his work, that he gives us salvation. We're called to make disciples. We're called to spread that message. And so we have purpose, even we, as in creation. We're part of creation too. And he made us with a very special purpose, and that's to make disciples. And so I hope you'll remember that this week. Parents, if you want further things to talk about with your children on what they discussed in VBS, that'd be a good starting point, asking those questions of why. And they should be able to tell you why certain things happen and why are we here and stuff like that. So I would encourage parents and family members and friends, if you want to follow up with things that we talked about in VBS, I would start there. Ask the important questions of why. And I promise you, these kids can answer. They can begin thinking about it even from an early age. So kids, thank you guys. I love you. I hope you have a good rest of the week and hope you have a good weekend. And before we go on to passing out certificates, I'd like to pray for you real quick. Is that okay?
All of our VBS kids, if y'all would come up here and make a nice little line up here at the front so that I can present you to the certificates. Tonight with a certificate of completion. They have formally ended our VBS. Give them a round of applause.